Hello and good day, my dear students. Now, what we are going to discuss is all about the historical development of art, okay? So, as an introduction, history shows the intrinsic value of art as a language that narrates the knowledge, belief, and experience of each generation of mankind. It shows the foundation of civilization through art, where humanity from the past to the present stipulates their desire for a better life. Now, let's see in the title kanina that history development. Okay, so we have two. We have the history and we have the development. Now, if we are going to understand this, okay, history has a different perspective. Development is a different dimension as well. But it is important for us to understand that the history takes part of the past, the present, and of course, the future, because it would shape the future. And the development is somehow different because this is development is ever-changing. No? It is ever-changing. And development means mayroong mga nangyari dati na dinevelop ngayon na pinag tutuunan ng pansin para mas mapaganda pa sa future. And that's development. Now, when we discuss about this thing, meron naman tayong sinasabi, historical development. Meaning, how does history developed, no, on the perspective of the arts? How does art now, no, sa Tagalog, paano ngayon itong art ay nagde-develop throughout the history? How this does this art changes over the time of history? Okay, so let's see this, that we started, no, we have at least 8, no, and in this topic, in this video, we have 2 parts. This is the first part and later on the second part, no, because this is too long, no. Una, we have the prehistoric, we have the Egyptian and Greek, Roman and medieval, Chinese and Japanese, Renaissance and Mannerism, Baroque and Rococo, Neoclassicism, and Romantic and Realism. Okay? So, in the history of art, prehistoric art refers to all artwork produced by ancient men before any preconceived culture and known methods of writing. The term cave art is the painting of drawing or of figures called petroglyphs or petroglyphs to portray a story or to record known history. So sa madaling sabi, hindi ko na papahirapan itong discussion na to. No. Dati ang mga tao ay nakatira sa kuweba. Bakit sila sa kuweba? Because that is the safe place para hindi sila habulin ng mga hayop, para hindi sila masaktan ng ibang mga hayop. Okay? And doon din sila kaya doon sila nakatira dahil doon nakaka-stuck sila ng mga pagkain, just like that is their house. Okay, now bilang bahay nila yon, okay, kumbaga sa ngayon ay no, nadodrawingan yung mga pader kapag may bata kang kapatid, ganun. Pero sa kanila dati, it is a different story. Sa kanila, ang kinakarve nila is yung mga nangyayari. Kaya nga minsan sa mga caves nakikita, ah, dito may nakatira, o dito may hayop na nakatira na pinalayas nila, na hinahabol sila, no? Hindi naman uso ang pagsusulat noon, ang pagnanarrate, kundi they use carved images. Okay? Kaya drawing of figures. Okay? Now, cave paintings or petroglyphs involves the application of pigment on the walls, floors, or ceilings of ancient rock dwellings inhabited by prehistoric men. Most of the prehistoric cave paintings were figures of animals. Ito yung sinasabi ko kanina, like bison and reindeer, horses, and tracing of human hands. Human figures were rarely shown and were usually highly stylized and far less naturalistic than the animal figures. An animal of this are the cave paintings which were found in 1870 at Altamira, Spain, by Don Marcelino and his daughter. These paintings are sometimes called the Sistine Chapel of Paleolithic Art. Okay. Dati wala pa namang, what do you call this, wala pa naman any formal materials for drawing. Ganun. Ang ginagamit lang talaga nila dati ay mga bato. Okay? Kung doon sila nag-curve, nag-carve. Okay? Ngayon, gumagamit lang sila ng kung anong pigment na nanggagaling sa nature. Diba? May mga halaman na nagkakaroon, pag ginawahan mo, may stain, mga prutas. Yun ang ginagamit nila para magkaroon ng pigment doon sa kanilang mga pinaglalagay. Okay? So, the term cave drawing or petroglyphs refer to an engraved drawing that is etched or done by cutting lines on the rock surface with a sharp object, probably a stone tool. Ito na yung sinasabi ko kanina. Okay? As this time, there is no clear idea when cave paintings first began. Researchers founded more than a dozen examples of wall painting across Spain that are more than 65,000 years old at Cueva de los Aviones. Researchers also found perforated seashells, beads, and pigments that are at least 115 years old. Okay, saan ba nag-start itong cave painting na to? We have the Paleolithic period and we have the Neolithic. When we speak about Paleolithic period, it is the Old Stone Age and the Neolithic is the New Stone Age. Okay? Dati, sa Paleolithic, if I'm not mistaken, stone tools lang to eh. No? Pero pagpasok ng Neolithic, dito na pumapasok ngayon yung mga metal na mga gamit for hunting, ganun, dito na sa Paleolithic pumapasok. Okay? Basta, sa Neolithic, sorry. Paleolithic, more on the stone material. Pagdating dito sa Neolithic, dito na pumapasok yung metal. Okay? So, saan na, dito naman sa Pilipinas, let's put it into context in the Philippines. Okay? So, the Angona Petroglyph Site Museum located in the municipality of Binangonan, Rizal, it was accidentally founded by national artist Carlos Botong Francisco, take note of that name, with a troop of Boy Scouts during a field trip in 1965. In Diyalab Mountain Province, carving on boulders on top of cliffs, dating was placed not earlier than 1500 BC. No? Petroglyphs in Peña Blanca Cagayan Cave or charcoal drawings on cave walls. Petroglyphs in Anda Peninsula. Bohol Red hematite prints dating of this is still undetermined. And themes that appear in the cave art. Okay. In the Philippine primitive art, before we go in the themes of the cave art. In the Philippine primitive art, it must be taken into consideration, no? Na hindi lang ito yung mga lugar na kung saan meron. For sure, marami pang iba. Because, tandaan po ninyo, no? This is an archipelago. When the Philippine is an archipelago, pag sinabing archipelago, it consists of many islands. And in an island, for sure, merong caves yan. For sure, meron niyang mga lugar na hindi pa nadi-discover. So this means po in the Philippine primitive art, no? Even before the Spaniards came or even before the discovery of the Philippines by the Spaniards, meron na mga nakatira dito. And siguro even before pa nga eh, no? Time, matagal. So, meron proof of existence ng mga tao dito, the presence ng mga tao na nanirahan sa kuweba in the Philippine Islands. Okay? Now, so what are the themes that may appear in the caves? Una is animals. Ito yung sinasabi natin kanina because sabi nga natin, nakatira mga tao sa mga cave just because to protect themselves from any harm. No? What are the signs? These are abstract symbols that are difficult to interpret because of their ambiguity. Signs are commonly associated with the hunting equipment and the female form. When we speak about signs, bakit siya nagiging ambiguous? Because there is no exact, take note of this, there is no exact interpretation of what is that. Kung ano yung sign na nilagay. Halimbawa, eto, you see this. It could be two or it could be a peace sign. Minsan nagiging misleading yung content noon. Bakit? Dahil nga, it is ambiguous that kahit ikwento mo yan, hindi mo maiintindihan dahil nga, it is only a sign. Pwede, pag sinabi kong ganyan, pwedeng two or pwedeng peace or it may be a different thing. Di ba? So, signs. That's why it is ambiguous. Next, humans. They are rarely depicted in caves. When they are shown, they are drawn as cartoon-like silhouette. Ito yung mga siguro na uso dito yung mga stickman dati, no? Dito yun, mga humans. So, we have animals, we have signs, we have humans. Now, tapos na tayo sa primitive art. Pasok tayo sa mundo ng Roman art, okay? Roman art began around 500 BC and ended at the fall of Rome in 1453 AD. Medieval art covers the production of art and artists in North Africa, Europe, and the Middle East. Roman art was developed largely because of the Roman Empire during the time of Romulus to Emperor Constantine. Okay? Roman art often depicted Roman mythology because of their belief in the power of gods. Artists also illustrated Roman emperors, particularly in sculpture. The Greeks were a great influence in Roman sculpture, but Roman portraiture showed the skills originality of the Romans by portraying their emperors, generals, and senators with a degree of realization to the Greeks. Okay, simple lang naman, sa Roman art, ang focus talaga nito ay hindi naman siya sa, ang Roman art, ang pinaka-focus talaga nito is more on the political side. Because the Romans back then, they have the laws now. May mga batas na sila, meron na silang kung ano-ano dyan. Kaya nga, the focus of Roman art is more on the politics. Okay? So, what are the great Roman art? This is the Aqueduct of Segovia, Spain, Cathedral, and the iconic Dome of Florence. Okay? And we also have the St. Peter's Basilica, and we have the Colosseum, no? And these images would simply portray or would simply help us understand na, bakit kaya ito yung focus? No, ito yung sinasabi ko kanina. Bakit sila naka-focus sa politics? Una, you have located the aqueduct. Ano bang aqueduct? Parang dam yan dati, no? Daanan ng tubig, waterway, kaya nga aqueduct. Mga ganun. So, meaning to say, gusto nila ang economic crisis, no? Para ma-provide yung needs ng mga tao. Next, meron tayo yung sa Florence, no? Yung buildings doon. Ano ibig sabihin noon? That dapat meron silang center na kung saan pwede silang magtipon-tipon. Mga ganun. We have the St. Peter's Basilica, no? Bakit kaya nandiyan yan? It is simply because to emphasize the faith, no, yung paniniwala, pananampalataya, no? Okay, and then we have the Colosseum. Ano ba dati, 'di ba? Dito naman kinokonsi sa mga persecutions dati, no? So, dito sa mga images na to, makikita talaga natin that the dominance of politics, okay, the dominance of politics in the Roman art, okay? So, during the medieval period, medieval art covered almost 10 centuries. So when we speak of 10th centuries, about 100 or more done, no? Between the sack of Rome and the early Italian Renaissance. Only one institution survived, the Christian Church, centered in Rome and Constantinople. The church became the main sponsor of architecture and the other types of art during the medieval era. In the beginning of the medieval period, all work of art are commissioned by religious authorities for churches and monasteries. Prominent use of valuable materials such as gold for objects in churches, jewelry, mosaic backgrounds. Okay, so eto na. Papasok na tayo sa medieval period. Okay, tanggalin muna natin si art sa medieval. Let's focus on the term medieval. During the medieval period, eto po kasi yung rise ng churches or the rise of faith, religion. Ito yung pinaka-center talaga ng medieval. Kaya yung mga tao dati dito, from the primitive, na ang alam lang nila is for survival, ngayon naman, as it changes, we go now to, from the ancient, we now, from the traditionals, we have the ancient, now we have the medieval. Ang way of thinking dito sa medieval lagi ay to interpret heaven on earth, to bring down heaven to earth. Yun lang ibig sabihin yan. No? Kung ano yung nakikita sa langit, no? Kung ano yung meron sa langit, ibababa dito sa lupa, ipapakita sa mga tao. Okay? Yun ang pinaka-objective ng medieval. Kaya nga ang pinaka-focus nila ay magtayo ng magagarbong simbahan. Dahil nga, to bring heaven on earth. Okay? Ibaba kung ano yung meron sa langit dito sa lupa based sa mga nababasa, sa mga kwento. Diba? Yan yun. So, the art historians generally classify medieval art into the following periods. Early medieval, Romanesque, and the Gothic art. No? Early medieval architecture was predominantly related to buildings, sacred buildings, such as churches, which was primary structure signifying Christian faith. The Roman Basilica was the primary model of medieval architecture. Castles and walls are the most notable examples of non-religious medieval structures. So that is the early medieval. No? More on talaga sa mga churches, basilicas, mga ganyan. Okay? Next. Romanesque architectural style flourished across the western part of Europe with France as the center of production and innovation. It took shape in the 11th century, initially developing in France, then spreading to Spain, Germany, Italy, and other regions. Romanesque buildings were characterized by semicircular arch, thick stone walls, sturdy pillars, barrel vaults, large towers, decorative arcading, and durable construction. Pre-Romanesque or Carolingian, this is the Carolingian period, was the North European style of the Renaissance in the late 8th and 9th century during the reign of Charlemagne. And the Ottonian architecture was the latter period of Romanesque developed under the reign of Emperor Otto the Great. So sculpture were prevalent during this time where stone was used to present biblical subject and church doctrines. Other significant media are stained glass and the tradition continues illuminated manuscripts. Okay. Ito na sinasabi ko kanina, no? To bring down heaven on earth. Ito yung pinakasimple na explanation nito. Gagamit ka ng mga magagarbong bagay, gagamit ka ng magagandang mga materyales, matitibay, and the design, it is intrinsic, no? Na malayo, maganda, pag nilapitan mo, mas maganda. Ganun yun. So, because they give emphasis on bringing heaven on earth. Again, yun lang naman kasimple yan. Now, let's have the Gothic art. Pagdating dito naman sa Gothic art, maraming mga signs dito. In the Gothic architecture, dito gumagamit sila ng mga various signs and symbols, pero it must be placed into consideration na dapat merong, the focus was, alam mo yun na, yung symbols natin ay dapat it must be readable and alam mo yun dapat medyo mas magarbo mga Gothic style mga ganun. Okay, so ano ba ang kinocompose ng Gothic architecture? Ito yung light, graceful, and mostly spacious in nature. Heavy piers were replaced by slender ones while window dimensions became larger as vaults and spires increased in height. So Gothic sculpture borrowed motifs from the architecture of the period since it was primarily used to decorate exteriors of cathedrals and other religious buildings. Ito yung sinasabi ko kanina. Yung pinaka-focus talaga nito ay ang, no? So, characteristics of the medieval arts. Now, it is rich colors, heavily outlined, flat and stiff figures showing no depth, religious icons, architecture is influenced by Greek and Roman, Byzantine, Romanesque, and Gothic styles emerge from this period. Mosaics replace carved decorations and large domes central to the church. Now, bakit kaya minsan tataka dome? Because circular yung focus nila and that is to give emphasis as well na the dominance yung kaya may dome, no? Yan yun. And one reason din ang sinabi nila dati is kaya dome yan because it is the shape of parang sky na it is an ending, no? It is an ending. Yun yung sinisimbolize niya, okay? Now, so, sa medieval churches and monasteries, this is still under the medieval period, that The Romanesque architecture featured pointed arch and heavily thick walls, small windows like the Roman style, a lot of its cultural decorations. Gothic structures featured pointed arch and have slender feel as if they soar upward, large stained glass windows filtered in light and color, and Byzantine structures featured large domes and that cover soaring spaces, arch and lavish decorations. Okay? So ganyan ang mga decorations natin during the ng mga medieval churches and monasteries, no? Some church actually ang churches kasi ito talaga yung dito nila nilalagay ang mga dome. Okay? Ang mga monasteries, more on mga pointed sila, mga pointed architectural ano sila. And yung mga stained glass windows na yan, merong dati, in my understanding, bakit may stained glass window? Because kapag nasisilawan ng araw, na-emphasize yung gusto niyang iparating, stained glass. Pero kapag hindi siya nasisikatan ng araw, no? Hindi niya na-emphasize. Parang nagiging ordinary na lang siya. Pero meron silang sinasabi that kailangan ng liwanag para makita ang ganda ng isang bagay. That's the same thing that's happening kasi that is the church. Okay? Okay? So, that's medieval churches and monasteries. Now, let's have various types of the medieval arts now. Ano ba ang mga consisting dito? Una, illuminated manuscripts, metalworks, and paintings. Una, illuminated manuscripts. These are religious texts decorated with rich colors which is often featured with the use of gold and silver. The word illuminated comes from the word illuminate meaning adorn. Okay. In the medieval art, don't get confused because sa medieval art po natin, ang pinaka-focus nito ay Catholicism. Okay? The Christianity. Okay? Kaya nga, bringing down heaven on earth. That is the main focus of the medieval art. Christianity, Catholicism. Now, in the illuminated manuscripts, no, kaya meron ngayon, no, yung mga magagandang book covers, yung makakapal, yung mga grandiose na mga book covers na ginagamit sa simbahan because part yun ng medieval art. Kasi dati, that ginagamit yun for display purposes. And even the texts ay nababalot ng gold, okay, or silver, no? Yun yung ano nun, because it is really used for display, no? Pinapakita. Okay, metalwork. Metals with great luster such as gold, silver, and bronze were frequently used as medium in the creations of religious artifacts. Metal workers transformed this beautiful metal into objects of adornment for such as sculptures, jewelry, and church doors. Okay? Kaya dati mabibigat ang mga pintuan because it is pure metal. No? Paintings. Pagdating naman sa paintings, ito yung iconography, fresco, and others. Portraits, no, yung mga paintings of saints, mga paintings ng all about the church, all about the things that is happening around the church, martyrdom, marami yan, maraming bagay sa paintings, okay? And then we have embroidery. It is made of colored wool. Alam naman natin yan, sewn together to form a continuous panel. Story of William the Conqueror, the Norman invasion of England, and the Battle of Hastings were embroidered in a linen 20 inches high and 230 feet long. Okay, that is the Bayeux tapestry. Okay, so embroidery, alam naman natin yan na yung mga tinatahi, no, gamit ang sinulid, tapos isang malaki yan. So, embroidery. And up until this time, ginagamit pa rin natin. No? Even lalo na sa mga vestments na ginagamit ng mga pare, mga ganun, karamihan doon, they are embroidery. Kaya, it is time-consuming but it is elegant. Okay? Ceramic art. Ito naman, yung sa ceramic art, ito naman yung mga ginagamit nila for utensils. Ito yung ginagamit nila for parang pottery. No? But they don't use clay. They use ceramics. Okay? Mosaics. Pag sinabi natin mosaics, ito yung katulad sa stained glass. Stained glass ay hindi naman yan ano eh. No? Hindi naman siya full na ano eh na may painting ganun, hindi eh. Pira-pirasong ano naman 'yan eh, pieces of glasses naman 'yan na pinag-isa. So, yung stained glass na 'yan, hindi lang siya basta drawing lang sa isang panel ng bintana kundi pira-piraso, no? So mosaics to present an image, okay? So ito na, sculpture, elongated styles of statues used in Romanesque art. So sculpture, ito yung how do they sculpt a certain person, no? A certain saint, a certain emperor, or basta under doon sa medieval period. Stained glass, ito na yung sinasabi natin kanina na use as fragmented pieces of glass. Ito yung sinabi ko kanina. Set to look like an image or a picture. The pieces are joined together by strips of lead supported by a hard durable frame. It was displayed to the windows of medieval churches, cathedrals, and castles. Ito yung sa stained glass kasi nagpo-portray siya ng kwento. Okay? It portrays a story minsan. And the heraldry, ito naman yung art and customs of creating coats and badges of the nobles. Okay? Heraldry, ito naman yung pagdating naman ng mga damit. Ganyan. Sa heraldry naman on how it uses as for depende sa ng society na nakabilang ka. Okay? So, there ends the discussion, the first part of the history of the historical development of arts. Meron pa tong part 2. So, I hope you have learned something on this discussion all about the historical development of art and yung mga succeeding dun napapasok ang Renaissance period. Okay? So, thank you, my dear students. I hope you have watched this video. Thank you. Keep safe and God bless everyone.